I'm now going to turn the mic over, you're welcome, to Mrs. Walters for the Arrow of Light ceremony, or are we doing your slideshow now? Okay. Slideshow it is.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this path and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Thank you. They gave them fire.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, our We Below Twos will be presented the Arrow of Light Award that they have worked very hard to earn. After that, a few of them will be crossing over to Boy Scouts and joining Troop 292. All of them will be graduating from Cub Scouts tonight and leaving our ranks. Most of these boys were sitting right where you were over 5 years ago, and someday, with hard work and dedication, you too will stand up here just like these boys. Please try to stay in your seats during the ceremony, since the lights will be out or very dim during most of it.
We Below Scouts of the Phoenix Patrol. When you first joined to form a part of our pack, the Cub Scout trail looked long and dark. You began immediately to earn your first badge, the Bobcat. When you received your Bobcat badge, the trail began to brighten. You then started to work with your den to earn your first rank badge. Together with your new friends, you earned your tiger badge. You worked in your den with your family and went on go see it. The trail started to get brighter. As the trail began to brighten, you began working on your next badge. Upon completing the 12 achievements of the Wolf badge, the trail became even brighter. After earning your Wolf badge, you began on your electives to earn your gold and silver arrow points. When you changed grade, you began working on your bear requirements. When you completed 12 of the 24 choices, you were presented with your bear badge. Again, you had the opportunity to earn gold and silver arrow points for this rank. When you entered the We Below Den, you began another exciting journey down the Cub Scout Trail. You earned your We Below badge with many activity badges. By this time, the trail was really bright. You have about reached the end of the Cub Scout Trail. and are ready to pass through to the next level of scouting. You've worked hard in lighting the trail, but there are other badges you wanted, the Arrow of Light Award. This is the highest award that a Cub Scout can earn. It is the only one a boy can wear throughout his scouting career.
What you see before you are candles to light the path through scouting. It is symbolic of growth, discovery, and adventure along a tailless trail. From his days as bobcat, wolf, bear, and weeblos, the scouting spirit has led him upward finally to the Arrow of Light. The arrow is straight and strong. 7 rays extend from this arrow, one for each day of the week when a weeblo scout will give goodwill. The 7 rays mean a great deal to the recipient of the Arrow of Light. Listen as each of the 7 great virtues is described and the spirit of true friendship and scouting is shown.
Wisdom. Wisdom does not necessarily mean superior knowledge. It means putting to right use the knowledge that one possesses. Courage. Courage is not the quality that enables men to meet danger without fear. It is being able to meet danger in spite of one's fear. Self-control. Self-control isn't limited to the control of one's temper, but control of oneself in all things, eating, playing, and even working and talking. Justice. Justice is the practice of dealing fairly with others without prejudice or regard to race, color, or creed. Faith. Faith is the conviction that something unproved and by physical evidence is true. One 8-year-old Cub Scout once said, "Faith was when you turned the light switch, you knew the light would go on." Hope. Hope means to expect with confidence. Always hope for better things to come. A man without hope is little good to himself or his community. Love. There are many kinds of love. Love of family, love of home, love of fellow man, love of God, and love of country. All these loves are necessary for a full life.
Let the spirit of scouting lead the bobcat, wolf, bear, and weeblos, and on to the Arrow of Light. Let that arrow show the way toward greater adventures in scouting. Let each ray emblazon a place upon your heart and soul, for these qualities will endure for a lifetime. Each boy will be presented with the Arrow of Light Award, a plaque and an arrow that is marked to show their achievements in Cub Scouting. Okay, would the parents of these scouts please come up? Michael McCormick. Parent, when we call the scout's name, parent, please come to your scout. Nicholas Muses. Yes. Thomas Walters. Jake Swalgen. Connor Payton.
Aiden Dennis. Steven Swagerski. And Evan Connor, please. This would be a great time for any of the folks if you want to get some pictures or whatnot for a moment while we change gears into the next section. We blow twos. We blow twos. What were you guys supposed to do after your birthday, my birthday announcement? Hey, Arrow, white guys. What were you guys supposed to do after my birthday announcement?
No, I remember.
What was it supposed to be? That's right. So you guys had a presentation for your leaders, Ms. Walters, Ms. Dennis. Sorry, this is a surprise one for you, Ms. Fiola. This is where we embarrass you with an embarrassing amount of thank yous.
So these ladies took it upon themselves to step up and guide, nurture, and care for these eight amazing, mature boys to get them to where they are today. It's been a long, rough 5 years, but I think I can speak for all of us and say thank you so, so much for what you have done. The slideshow, that said it. There's nothing else to say.
So let me explain how that was supposed to happen. After birthdays, they were supposed to jump up and say, wait! But they missed their cue and they rolled right into the Arrow of Light ceremony, so we kind of had to do that out of sequence. So, back to our regularly scheduled program.
Just one more thing, though.
The boys can take a seat, please. You ladies, stay here, please. Mrs. Lewis, and but also Joey Mariano, please come up and join the group.
short and hot. Now let's go dance, please.
Okay, this is probably the only time we get a chance before these people sneak off to thank them for all their hard work over the years. Many hands make light work, and these hands did great work. These boys and the boys that are still in the pack wouldn't be able to have the amount of success that they have been able to enjoy without folks like these. And so, and this is just a small token of appreciation for all of you. And of course, Miss Fiona is not leaving us, but, you know, if I don't get the gift in now, in a few years from now, she'll take off and I'll never get to do it, so I got it now. All right, so, Dick, each one of the large bags for the ladies, and the green bag is for Joey. And Joey is an assistant senior patrol leader with Boy Scout Troop 292. He was the den chief for these boys throughout this past year and did an amazing job. Really stepped up to the task and has been one of our better den chiefs based on the reports from the boys. Kim, you weren't supposed to sit down. He said, "Can you stay?" They didn't have four kind of leading colors as close as I could get. So, all right, thank you to you all again. And the door's always open if you want to come volunteer. All right. On to the next part of the show.
Hey boys, my scouts, you have reached a high point in your journey, which leads from being a boy to being a man. You have reached the end of Weeblow's trail and are ready to start wonderful scouting trail. We are proud of you. Before you go, we must be certain that you are well prepared for scouting trail. Leader of this pack, Mr. Danforth, are you satisfied that these boys are ready to leave the pack and start upon the scouting trail?
Michaela, I am certain.
Leaders of Troop 292, you have heard the leader of the pack say that these Weeblos are ready to begin the scouting trail. Are you ready to receive them into your troop and lead them along the path of scouting? My scouts, all eight of you, please stand. Face Mr. Danforth and salute those leaders who have worked with you and counseled with you so that you may grow beyond the den. As you have learned, the Arrow of Light is the only badge of Cub Scouting which may be worn on the Boy Scout uniform. It signifies the highest achievement of which a Cub Scout may attain. I'm pleased to see that you're wearing the Arrow of Light. Now, in the presence of your pack leader, your den leaders, your parents, and friends, please repeat the Cub Scout promise with me one more time. I promise to do my best, to do my duty to God and my country, to help other people, and to obey the law of the pack. You may sit down. I want to say these final words to you. The trail is sometimes hard. Easier paths may be tempting to you, but if you remember the scout law and oath which you have just given, and keep these things in your heart, you will stay on the right path. Okay. Will the parents of these scouts please stand?
Michael, Thomas,
with your help, your sons have grown a little taller tonight. In scouting, just as in Cub Scouting, your sons will need your help and guidance and support so that they may follow the trail to the eagle. For those whose boys will be crossing over to Troop 292, would you please take a moment to remove their Weeblow's hat, neckerchief, and colors from their sleeves. Also remove the epaulets. It is now time for us to leave. We hope there will be happiness and rejoicing among the members of this pack. For these sons who have brought you pride and honor, may your trails be long and happy ones.
Mr. Scott, Scoutmaster of Troop 292, these Weeblow Scouts have completed the Cub Scout Trail and are eager to join your troop.
Stand and give the scout sign. Senior patrol leader, please lead the troop in the scout oath and the scout law.
I promise to do my best, to do my duty, to God and my country, to obey the scout law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. A scout be is trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, courteous, kind, obedient, cheerful, thrifty, brave, clean, and reverent.
Ready, two. Thank you, Lord. New Scouts, you will be expected to live by the Scout Oath and the Scout Laws. We expect you to uphold the ideals and the program of our troop. You will be expected to keep good attendance at all Scout events. Most of all, you will continue representing the spirit of scouting by being a living example of scouting ideals in your daily life. I welcome you to the Brotherhood of Scouting and Troop 292. Troop, please welcome our new scouts by presenting them with their troop hat, Boy Scout shoulder loops, troop numerals, and Boy Scout handbook. and gentlemen, the new Boy Scouts of Troop 292.
Thank you, Troop 292. On your way, boys.
All right.
You are excused. Do good or do well.